If you want to take real-world phenomena and represent them visually on a digital map, you're going to have to choose between the vector and raster formats. The vector format is simply shapes, either points, lines, or polygons. The advantage is that the shapes retain their geometry, no matter the scale. Zooming in does not make the shapes pixelated. The shape is precise and is fixed based on its set vertices. Vector data is best used, but not exclusive to, data that is discrete. For example, in a map of North America, the Rocky Mountains would be best represented by a polygon with precise vertices. Whereas if we wanted to know the different elevations of the area, a polygon might be confusing. We'd need something else, but more on that later. Vector is great when precision is necessary. So in displaying the boundaries between properties, for example, vector is essential, or else people will get upset. The raster format consists of a grid made of cells. Like any photo, this means that resolution is important. The lower the resolution, the less precise the data. But the higher the resolution, the more storage it takes up. The advantage to raster, though, is the ability to store large quantities of data from large swaths of area and have the ability to conduct mathematical operations. Raster is better equipped for data that is continuous rather than discrete. While representing the boundary of a mountain range would likely be better recorded in vector format, the raster format would be better suited to record the elevation. Because each cell holds a numeric value, calculations can be performed. For example, if we know the elevation of every cell, we can easily run a calculation to determine the slope. Both vector and raster data can be used, and often used together, to obtain geographic information that is truly insightful. As they say, raster is vaster, but vector is corrector. And until next time, thanks for watching.